One of the earliest examples of monoprints, Giovanni Benedetto. This is an example of a reductive monoprint. You can really see the use of chiaroscuro in there, the kind of play between light and dark. He's inked up a plate and taken the ink away in that area, and that's how you get the kind of the light bouncing off the figures. So this creamier area is just the colour of the paper shining through because there hasn't been ink lying on the plate in that area. Got Grady Gordon, some gruesome monoprints there, you know, Halloween's coming up and all that. I really love his work. So simple technique of rolling ink onto the plate, using a squeegee rubber or a piece of card, you know, whatever he's using, he's scraping into the ink to get these marks, taking ink away in certain areas, quite haphazardly there, and then more kind of deliberate here with the teeth marks, scratching into the ink with different materials, spreading the ink in different ways. So they're one-off prints, they're really nice. Rob Peel, he's probably used multi-plates to produce this, using lots of different colours, stencils as well. Might have used a stencil to print a block colour over the top. So when you produce monoprints and you reveal that print, that might not be, you know, the end of the story. You might want to use multiple plates. You could even prepare 5, 6, 7 plates at the same time and print them over the top of each other in the same printing session. You could even leave it a few weeks and then look at your monoprint and see where you want to go from there, just like you would a painting, kind of treat it in quite a reactive way and just keep printing over the top. He's added some kind of linear marks here as well. He could have, I don't know, done a bit of chincolé, sticking tissue paper to the prints, a little bit of direct trace monoprint there as well. He could have even, drawn directly onto it, hand-coloured it in some ways. So your monoprint is a method in which you can, you know, create images, but you can also add things to that. You can even screen print over it, produce a dry print point over the top. Even feel free to, on your dry point session in a few weeks, bring back some of your monoprints if you want to, and you can print over the top of them. You know, the possibilities are endless, really. Marcin Kuligowski, I think that was meant to say Kuligowski, sorry. But this is a mixture of direct trace and kind of additive and reductive monoprint. We've got the kind of taking away of ink here, some direct trace, more linear qualities there. You can actually see there where the ink's been wiped away, but not quite enough. And he will have just produced many plates and printed them simultaneously over the top of each other as well. Chris Mullins, more abstract piece, landscape. Literally rolling ink and scratching into it and printing multiple layers over the top. Really nice. You can see a kind of white mark there where he possibly could have used solvent to disperse the ink as well. It's a nice idea. Another one by Chris Mullins. He's printed the dark ink over the light, and as he's wiped away this ink, you can see the colour coming through as well. Quite atmospheric. So Murray Zimmelees, Die with Honour, Wounded Fighter. So this part of the print is the monoprint. This is actually a lithograph. So it's just an example of how printers can use different methods at the same time on the same print. You can see the kind of splatting of ink there, very painterly. Marilyn Kyle, this is where you can monoprint with actual objects. If they're soft enough to go through the press, that's, you know, great, and you can experiment with that. if we've got time at the end of the session, I'll do a demonstration with just a glove, and you can see how you can get an impression from that. Cloves, I think Emily, a level six student last year, did some really beautiful, delicate monoprints of kind of lace underwear. They come out absolutely gorgeous. The detail on them is beautiful. So in this case, we've used a little children's dress. And it almost looks like it's an x-ray almost of the actual object. It's really quite a nice effect. And you get a really nice embossing of the object as well on the paper. Chuck Close, he's done a series of portraits in different medias. This one is just a series of thumbprints that he's created a monoprint out of. So even something simple as a thumbprint, a stamp, is essentially a monoprint. Morgan Doyle, I found his work in watching too much Netflix, in a magazine, Printmaking Today. It's a quarterly magazine that I get. I've got loads of them down here. Feel free to have a look through if you want to look for inspiration of modern day printmakers that are actually practicing today. This is one in the latest edition, actually. And he prints on very large plates and in multiples as well. So he might prepare 7 plates and print them over the top of each other. Sometimes when he feels he might have gone too far in the print, that he will literally just roll ink using the roller straight onto the print without putting it through the press. Maybe knock it back with some whiter areas here and here as well. Kind of knock it back as in knock it back with some white areas in colour. Yeah, this area might have been a bit too dense, he might have felt. So he will just roll on white ink just to get the contrast.
How long do you have for that process of taking it off?
Well, it's oil-based ink, so it doesn't dry very quick at all. You probably, if you're working on a plate, you'll have a few hours to work on a plate before you can before it kind of starts drying up and things. So yeah, that's the benefit of using oil-based inks. Sometimes people use acrylic-based block printing inks, but that can kind of dry up really quickly, actually. So oil-based is best for that. And this is Morgan Doyle again, but he has taken some of his monoprints and collaged with them. So if you're not happy with a couple of prints, or you could be very happy with them, but you feel that they would work better as a collage, you can do that. Can collage, then maybe scan it in, do a screen print of it, do a few screen prints, collage with that, scan it in, trace it in a mono print. You know, the possibilities are endless. You could keep going with it. Helen Frankenthaler, these are very painterly mono prints and very abstract. So this looks like just one layer to me, so it's the kind of other end of the scale to Morgan Doyle. Looks like she's kind of loosened the ink with solvents there. A bit of additive there, so you're literally, it's quite a posh word for saying, you know, you're just adding ink to the plate, essentially you're painting, creating a painting on the plate and then printing it. And that's another one of Helen Frankenthaler's, but a lot looser ink there. You can monoprint with inks, you can monoprint with watercolour as well if you wanted to. The difference is that when you have your plate that you're working on, it needs a key. So that means it needs a rough surface for the watercolour to adhere to. If you imagine painting watercolour straight onto a plastic sheet, it's going to just run off. So if you are going to be using watercolour for doing monoprinting, I'd sand the plate slightly before you work, and then usually you would paint your image onto the plate, let it dry before you print it. We're not going to be running through watercolour mono printing today, but if you do want to go through that, just pop down at a different time and we can go through that. So I probably mentioned a lot of these. So developing mono print further, you can keep building up layers, so using multi-plate printing. Collage backgrounds, so you can apply a collage first, or on top of your plate when you're printing, which is a technique called shinkolay, which we'll go through in your dry point workshop. You can physically collage with your prints, direct trace over your plate prints, use multi-print processes together. You can experiment with scale. You know, you could do a stamp size mono print. You could do a print which is, I don't know what's the maximum there, about 6 foot by 3.5 foot on there. And we've got some acrylic plates at the back there that you're welcome to use. So that's one benefit of this studio. We've got the Takash press, so you can really increase the scale of that. Watercolour monoprints were already mentioned. Screen print monotypes, which is something a workshop that will offer in level 5. And that is the same principle where you're producing one-off prints but with screens. So you're doing monotypes on the screen beds. That's another way to develop it. Scan and digitally manipulate monoprints as well. A lot of the graphic students tend to use monoprints as a texture or a background within their work, something that you might want to do. Or even if you're producing screen prints, for example, you might want a bit of a texture, so you might monoprint onto tracing paper, then take that into the UV room and expose it on a screen. We'll go into that more during your screen print induction. But that's another way of thinking about monoprinting. You can even monoprint onto tracing paper and take it into the dark room to do contact prints as well. And that's something you can chat to myself or Craig about as well. It's another nice idea. Risograph, which is this here. It looks like a photocopier, but it's halfway between a screen printing machine and a photocopier. You can take your monoprints and copy them and produce numerous prints in the same way as you produce monoprints. Each colour is a different layer. So you can produce multi-layer risographs, which are just above the machine there. That's some of the examples. So it works in the same way, the same principles for screen printing. You can use monoprints as backgrounds for other prints, and you can monoprint during life classes if you wanted to. Just an idea there. You could ink up a plate and take the plate into your life class, draw from life, come down and print it in the studio as well. That's another option. Even with etching as well, which we'll go through during your etching workshop. Just might be a nice idea to incorporate drawing from life into your prints as well.